It's the beginning of a new year, a new season with new opportunities, bringing together rookie drivers and experienced veterans. Much like the track itself, the combination of new and old make for a dynamic race. Canadian Tire Motorsport Park has a storied past with a modern feel, a perfect paved playing field for the Pinty Series Championship. Fresh, young drivers filled with aspirations will tackle this legendary track head-on to make a name for themselves. While the more experienced racers know that this old motorsport circuit must be respected. The 2016 championship starts now. From Canadian Tire Motorsport Park near Bowmanville, Ontario, this is the Clarington 200. It's the first race of the 2016 NASCAR Pinty Series. Hello, everyone, and welcome to a beautiful day and a beautiful start to the Canadian motorsports calendar. I'm Dave Bradley. Along with me is the voice of the NASCAR Pinty Series, Adam Ross. Todd Lewis and Tanya Beaudin will be patrolling the pits for us here today. But Adam, new start to a new season and a brand new name for this Canadian series.
Pinty's Foods is a great supporter of racing and sport in Canada. They've stepped up big time to sponsor this series.
And the schedule is an interesting one. We have 12 events in 2016 at 11 different facilities. It's crisscross the country. And we have a new event this year. The Toronto Indy is back on the schedule, a street circuit. That's going to be fun.
Fun, fast, and tight. The series last visited the Toronto Indy in 2011. Andrew Ranger dominated the 2.8-kilometer street circuit. The teams are excited to get back to the streets of Toronto.
And of course, we'll be talking about the championship battle throughout the 2016 season, but there'll be a battle within that as well in the 2016 Justin's Rookie of the Year championship, and two familiar faces because they have dabbled in the series in the past. Kevin Lacroix will make an attempt at a full season, and so will Josh Collins coming from Newfoundland.
One is an expert road racer, one is a talented short track racer, and if there's one thing we know in this series, never count out the rookies. Last year at this race, Gary Clute, as a rookie, won the event, went on to win Justin's Rookie of the Year.
And with more on today's race, let's head down trackside. Todd Lewis is standing by with your E3 spark plugs pole sitter.
Thanks, guys. Great to be back again for another season. Our first E3 spark plugs pole winner of the year is Alex Labbé, the Victoriaville, Quebec driver, picks up the third pole of his NASCAR Pinty Series career. He's still looking for that first series victory as well. This is his first pole on a road course. Now he'd like to have his first victory here as well. Alongside on the front row, well, you're not at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park if you're not seeing the 27 car of Andrew Ranger alongside on the front row. The all-time series wins leader is looking to add to that total today. A bit of a change up on the 27 team this year, though. Dave White slides over from the 17 team to be the crew chief, although he's not here today because of a NASCAR infraction, so it's Lawrence Roy who's going to be calling the shots on the pit box. Going to be a great race this afternoon, and look for these two drivers to be hard chargers for the full 51 laps.
And Andrew Ranger always races well here, doesn't he?
And he's fast this weekend, Dave, but there's 26 other drivers that are pretty quick as well.
And they're all buckled in and ready to go. Let's head down trackside for today's command. Here for the first event of the series. Big thanks to Natalie Davis from Castrol and NASCAR legend Robert Yates for the command.
Well, Dave, Mr. Yates is here as a guest of Ed Hackinson and Pinty's, and Robert Yates Racing does a lot of work with the spec engine program widely used in the series.
We'll have a number of onboard views for you here today, and one coming on the 67 of David Thorndike. There's a good look at LP Dumoulin. Big storyline surrounding that team here in 2016. Kaz Grala making his first start in the NASCAR Pinty Series here at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park. And as the cars roll off, let's take a look at the Leland starting lineup. Alex Labbé and Andrew Ranger on the front row. And row number two has Pierre Lacoulette in the 18, Gary Clute in the 59.
Third row, brings us former champion LP Dumoulin in the WeatherTech 47 and the Rebestos number 3 of Jason Hathaway. DJ Kennington in row number 4 alongside the youngster Kaz Growlin.
Row 5 has JF Dumoulin in the 04 and Matthew Skinnell, driver of the 56. Row 6, Caden Lapsevich in the 76, and there's Kerry Mix in the 02.
Row number 7 brings us the legendary motor car 42 of Ryan Clute and veteran Robin Buck in the number 1 Dodge. In the 8th row, Patrick Dussault in the 71 and the 06 of Carlos De Quezada.
There's Kevin Huatras in the 8 car and Anthony Simone in the 95. That makes up row number 9. Brett Taylor making his very first start behind the wheel of the 46. David Michaud is in the 40.
Row number 11, Simone Dion Vienne in the 37 and the 25 of Joey McComb. In the 12th row, Larry Jackson in the 84 and Brian Cathcart makes his return to the series in the 75.
Mel Shaw behind the wheel of the 87. David Thorndike drives the 67 and rounding out the field in the 74 is Kevin Laquan. How about the bumper-to-bumper team led by crew chief Don Thompson Jr. putting that machine back together after a heavy crash in practice?
And Dave, the parts they didn't have to repair that race car, they actually fabricated and repaired.
It was a long night, and we'll take a look at the E3 Spark Plugs race analysis. And Adam, a fun track and a fun race.
51 laps the distance, 200 kilometers today, Dave, on this 3.9 kilometer, 10-turn road course.
And it's a beautiful day for racing, 23 degrees and sunny. Let's head back pitside to Todd with today's Leland lead up to the green.
Guys, this is an unfamiliar spot for Scott Steckley, normally behind the wheel of the number 22 car. He is overseeing his 3 entries this year. Not to say he's closed the door completely on driving, but concentrating on ownership. Pierre-Luc Ouellette will be in one of his cars today, the 18, subbing for Alex Tagliani, and Kaz Grala, the hot 17-year-old who's been competing in the K&N series, also behind the wheel today. Another team worth keeping an eye on, the CBRT team, with Joey McComb driving one of the entries and also overseeing a 4-car team here today.
Gary Cluth had a remarkable 2015 season as he captured his first NASCAR victory at this race after a dramatic finish. Then he won Rookie of the Year, and this week he was chosen to be part of the NASCAR Next Class. Great achievements and bright future for the 20-year-old driver. Unfortunately, 2016 season is starting with a bit of struggles as they had to change 3 motors in the car.
And Tanya, he'll have a lot of work to do today. You can see that car dropping to the back right now, and that is because of that engine change. His crew chief John Fletcher had his hands full in the pits.
It was a stressful day for them yesterday. Clute to the back, Anthony Simone also going to the back for unapproved changes. So those two drivers have a lot of race cars in front of them at the green, Dave.
Yeah, they'll join the 74 of Kevin Lacroix right at the back as the field makes its way through turn number 10, looking for the green flag. It is the legendary Robert Yates with green flag in hand on the front shoot, and we're underway in the NASCAR Pinty Series in 2016.
Start, Dave, to clear Andrew Ranger, and that's what he got. Open racetrack for LeBay.
And he is not laying back. You can see that car get a little bit crooked off turn 2. We're clean through turn number 3, and this track will bite you very quickly. We talked about respecting the race course off the top of the show, and that's what these drivers have to do early on as these tire pressures start to come up.
Elevation changes, tight corners. Here we see some side-by-side moves. Cars to the outside. That's Kevin Quatras trying to go high in turn 5.
You saw Gary Clute making a move, too. That car very distinct on the racetrack. A yellow hood and blue front fenders as he continues to march his way up from the back of the pack, but single file at the front of the field here in the early going. On board the WeatherTech.ca, number 47 of LP Dumoulin. And again, we talked about the storyline surrounding this team. LP starting up a brand new team with his brother, JF, and moving to Trois-Rivières, his hometown. So they're doing it all on their own this year for the first time.
New team with brand new equipment, new crew chief Billy Burns. He knows what it takes to win a championship as well.
Alex LeBay will lead lap number 1 here of the Clarington 200, picking up those all-important bonus points. It's the first race of the year, but they are thinking big picture.
Kaz Grala runs in the sixth position in Scott Steckley's number 22. And I'm impressed with this 17-year-old from the U.S., Dave. He understands the 22's never won on a road course, and it would mean a lot to him to get it to victory lane. He spoke about it a couple of times yesterday.
Yeah, he knows how much that would mean for team owner Scott Steckley, and Kaz Grala very mature behind the steering wheel of that number 22 race car. Top three there. Alex LeBay in the 32. There's Andrew Ranger in the 27. And third place, currently the 18 of Pierre Lecoulet.
Listen to that Mopar power under the hood of Andrew Ranger. We got a Ford out front, a Chevy, a Dodge running second, and a Chevy running third, Dave.
It's pretty cool to see all the different makes at the front of the field. Jason Hathaway, LB Dumoulin currently rounding out the top five. And a battle for 16th spot between the 40 and the 59 heating up as we move through turn number eight. David Michaud in the 40 up on the outside as Gary Klute continues to try and head towards the front of the field.
He's wasting no time, started all the way at the back. He's already up nearly a dozen spots, Dave.
We knew Kevin Lacroix in that bumper-to-bumper Total Lubricants number 74 would be moving up as well, and now we ride on board.
Well, one thing we don't know, and he doesn't know either, is how good that race car is. The repairs they had to work all night long, fabricating pieces. There's a lot of unknowns for this driver.
Hey, doesn't know whether or not he can push it too hard. Don Thompson Jr. looked absolutely exhausted this morning. He was dirty, he was tired, but he had it together, and that's all that mattered as the team was putting vinyl on the back quarters to make it look pretty to get it out for the starting grid earlier on.
If I could choose my crew chief to go through that grind, Dave, it'd be Don Thompson Jr. He's been doing this a long time.
There's a battle for 10th spot. Matthew Skinnell currently holds that 10th position in the Omvik Dodge. Robin Buck, and there's Caden Lapcevich in the 76 in that dice as well. And Lapcevich without a sponsor on board, but he's hungry for a good showing here today.
And you know, they weren't fantastic in practice yesterday, but they got better and better, qualified better still, and he's racing pretty darn well following Robin Buck down the long back straightaway.
You know, I talked to his dad, Jeff Lapcevich, before this event, and I said, how does he like this road racing stuff? Because he cut his teeth on ovals, and he says, you know what? He loves racing. That's all he loves to do, and we are racing here at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park. Alex LeBay is your leader in the early going of the Clarington 200. The opening round of the 2016 NASCAR Pinty Series is brought to you by Mopar, authentic performance. By Leland Industries, a proud Canadian fastener company. And by Honeygoo by CleanFlow, a honey of a lube. Alex LeBay continues to lead here at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park, followed by Andrew Ranger. Pierre Lecoulet is holding down third spot. Jason Hathaway fourth, and fifth is a man in the 47 WeatherTech Dodge, LP Dumoulin.
And the top three have pulled away by a little bit of a margin. I would expect these veterans behind LP Dumoulin leading that pack, they're just taking their time. Dave, there's pit stops, and we've got a problem. Anthony Simone, as we talk about pit stops, this is not a scheduled stop. We're too early in the event.
No, Simone was falling back since the drop of the green flag. The crew had battled rear-end problems in practice yesterday, and it looks like this one, not a scheduled stop. They're going to dive underneath to see what they can fix. But the good news for that team is these laps take a long time to complete, so they do have a little bit of time on their side.
And Jeff Walt and the crew will go to work. They thought they had found the problem. There were some filings in the rear end, and they thought they knew what was going on, but clearly more trouble for the Simone 95.
Battle for fifth spot. There goes Kaz Grala to the inside of the 47 of LB Dumoulin. The 22 tucks back in line eight. Turn number eight is not a great place to pass. Turn 10 could be, and here comes DJ Kennington to the inside of the 22. Problems for Klute.
That's Ryan Klute in the 42. Of course, his brother Gary blew two engines yesterday. And the way that smoke's coming out the exhaust, I think this is engine number three for the Klute team.
And that is horrible news. The Klute luck continues here at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park. And this means the first full course caution of the day here in the Clarington 200. Two Klutes in a line down the back straightaway.
That could be horrible news. Obviously, Ryan Klute with problems with the engine, but oil on the racetrack, that could have ended the day for Gary Klute as well. Pit road is a buzz. Many of the leaders are headed down pit lane to the attention of their crews. We see Alex LeBay and the Kappa crew taking on fuel.
And Adam, they are in their fuel window. We'll see a bunch of different strategies playing out. There's the 27 of Ranger, and here comes Ouellet. Todd?
18 car makes it to pit lane. A little difficulty. Almost tucked in behind the 27. Crew going to work now on the left side tires. Just ahead of them, the 3 car with that new Revesta sponsorship. Also working on left side tires. We thought we'd see pit stops early. This caution flag has provided the opportunity.
Dave, I did not expect 4 tire changes on this first yellow. They normally come in and fuel up at this point.
And you saw the hood go up quickly on the 47 of LB Dumoulin, but a change for the lead. DJ Kennington's out front. We ride on board the 67 of David Thorndike, who sits in 10th place as we head to the first restart of the day. DJ Kennington continues to lead in his Castrol-Edge Dodge, followed by Robin Buck in the number 1, the return of a veteran to the NASCAR Pinty Series.
And we've shuffled the deck, 2 veterans up front, and then Caden Lacevic and Kevin Poitras in row number 2 as we go back to green.
And look, a young Caden Lacevic dives to the inside of the water. Robin Buck in through turn number 1 side by side.
Such an impressive young man. It doesn't look right that there's no logos on that 76 car.
You know what? Keep putting in good performances and companies will notice as Caden Lacevic slides in behind the veteran Robin Buck. Now he'll make a move to the inside of turn number 3. Tries down the inside as a driver a little bit further back locked up the right front going into turn 3.
And there was contact between Caden and Robin Buck. He's not scared to mix it up with these guys.
And nor is Robin Buck. And if you talk about somebody who knows this facility, it is Robin Buck. He's a performance driving instructor here at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park. So he knows his way around.
Oh, hard contact, Dave. Patrick Dusso in the 71, hard into the DLVN number 37. I can't believe they both carried on.
Yeah, DLVN was right sideways in turn number 5 as you take a look at the running order. A couple cars, few laps down. Anthony Simone in the number 95 and Ryan Clute now 6 laps down to your race leader.
We go on board with Gary Clute in the Pioneer Family Pool sponsored number 59 as he rolls up on the rear deck lid of Matthew Scannell in the Omvic 56.
Something new to our broadcast here in 2016. You'll see the gap back to the leader on the ticker across the top of your screen so you can better track your favorite driver as the race goes on.
Nice pass there by Gary Clute. Always fun to have new technology. And after that contact, DLVN smoking a little bit.
And possibly a tire, Robin. You don't want to see that because these fenders can cut down those Goodyear Eagles in just a few laps. So it might sort itself out. But no doubt the crew, we got a car around. The 46.
That's Brett Taylor from Calgary, Alberta, making his debut with the series. Wow, 3 wide into turn number 3. You can't do that.
And you're right, you can. Larry Jackson will go for a spin to the outside at turn number 3. He manages to gather it back up, and he'll tag back on. Just a local caution. Not a full. Now it is
full course.
I see the caution from the corner worker as we had a couple of problems.
We're going to go on board Kevin Lacroix, the bumper-to-bumper 74, tries to squeeze it in. No, he didn't try to squeeze it in.
We should mention that this caution is for debris in turn number 9. That is the debris. So somebody lost their rear bumper cover, and that's the reason for this caution, as we had action really all over this racetrack. Here's the first problem.
Wow, significant contact between the 46 and Taylor, and that's Gary Clute. And that's a lot of damage to the front end of Clute's car.
Number of drivers come down pit lane, including your leader, Todd.
DJ Kennington taking advantage of the second yellow period to make his scheduled stop. They're packing full of fuel. They will call him back in for another round and change all 4 Goodyear Eagle tires. A quick stop under the second caution for the 27 car as well. Now there's a problem with the intake on that fuel cell. That's a could be a problem for the 27 team.
You can see that intake just pushed right through as the fuel carrier went to go put the fuel can into the tank. It's gone. They can't get gas into that car. That's going to be a problem for the 27 of Andrew Ranger. We continue under caution. Simone DLVN is your leader.
On board your 2015, Johnston's Rookie of the Year, Gary Kluwt in the Pioneer Pools 59, as we're set to go back to green. I'm Adam Ross, along with Dave Bradley. Todd Lewis and Tanya Bodan are trackside, Dave.
And it's Simon Delvien who will lead him back to green here on the front straightaway. Gary Kluwt with that mangled front end of the 59 up on the outside. He'll hang right there. Jason Hathaway, and how about the youngster Skinnell in the Omvic Dodge? He really impresses everybody each time he comes to Canadian Tire Motorsport Park.
He absolutely does, and through strategy, they generally get to the front of the field. That restart wasn't very friendly for the 56, but look at Hathaway. He's already pitted, and he's back up well in the top five.
JF Dumoulin and the Spectra Premium 04, brand new sponsor for that team here in 2016, holding down third spot. That's a good news story, as that company really getting behind the NASCAR Pinty Series. They're designing a radiator to work for this car. Should be ready enough to test by the end of 2016. A cool story.
That is very cool, and we see the gap open between first and second. Simon Delvien is Gary Kluwt being overtaken by Dumoulin down into turn eight.
In these cars because of the short tracks that they're normally on, but here at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park, you're down that Andretti straightaway. That crumpled front end may hurt Gary Kluwt.
And contact in turn 10, Cascarella making an aggressive move, couldn't quite get it done. And what we could be seeing, Dave, are two things. One, aerodynamics, but we don't know if that car might be overheating with all that damage to the ductwork.
Alex LeBay taking advantage of the inside in the 32 Can-Am sponsored Ford Fusion. He's side by side with Cascarella into turn number two. That's not a great place to be side by side. He'll back off a little bit and let Gralla go this time.
Fast turn, and all your momentum is taking you down the hill. Off the racetrack, they did a great job to keep those cars straight.
Gralla's able to pick up a spot, though. Dives underneath the 59 of Gary Kluwt and tucks back into line. We're single file back at the front of the field. Simon Delvien continues to lead. What a run for the driver, that 37.
By far the best performance we've seen out of this driver in his time with the series. That's JF Dumoulin applying the pressure, a gifted road course racer. And look at the damage on the 18 of Ouellette.
Down this big, long back, Mario Andretti straightaway. It's the Best Buy Fiesta Ducto, number 37 of Simon Delvien, and a battle for second. Jason Hathaway has a run over the outside of JF Dumoulin into turn number eight.
And the outside can be a great place to pass into eight. You keep that momentum, and you can drive a little deeper into the corner, Dave.
And you can see there, that's what new Goodyear Eagles will do for you. Give you that stick out of the corner and help you get that jump down the straightaway.
Did he ever close in on the leader there as they head down into turn one and look at him right to the bottom of the racetrack, keeping the pressure on.
Hathaway never really known as a road course ace or specialist, but he won here at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park last fall, so he is pretty good.
And he'll even tell you, he kind of makes light of it, that it's not his forte, but boy, for someone who's not great at something, he's sure pretty good at it.
He sure is. He took the lead like it was given to him as Simon Delvien pulled to the inside. Hathaway in the Ray Bestis number three, your new leader. Here comes Dumoulin in the dirt a little bit, looking for second.
And we've got him side by side. That's LeBay looking up the inside of JF Dumoulin. Oh, backs out of it.
Little contact in through 5A, now B, and onto the back straightaway. You can see some oil or some sort of fluid on the front windscreen of the number 32 of Alex LeBay.
Look how much time they have to decide what move they want to make on that straightaway. There's hills, there's turns, and JF Dumoulin going to drop to the inside.
And look at the lead. The three of Jason Hathaway is built up. Dumoulin will hold on to second for turn number eight. LeBay will pull up into third spot. Here comes Pierre-Luc Ouellet in the 18 to the outside of turn number nine. He'll dive to the inside of turn 10, and into the pit lane goes the 22 of Cascarella.
And he darted off the racetrack. Look at the damage to the front grille of that 22 as we go on board the Descartes machine.
And when the field is under green, it must feel like an eternity for Cascarella at pit road speed limit. But he'll get to the service of his crew as Jason Hathaway continues to lead under green. One of the most popular places in the paddock is the Pinty's Trackside Grill here at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park, and for good reason. Those wings are good.
That's Tony Spiteri himself directing traffic. That is good wings.
Back to the action, though, and how about DJ Kennington, the Castrol Edge Dodge, taking a look on the 37 of Simone Dion-Vienne. That's a battle for eighth position on the racetrack.
Right behind him, the veteran in the Ford Fusion, Kerry Mix, in the Johnsonville number 02 Ford. I felt so bad for Kerry. They are so frustrated chasing a vibration in that race car that they just can't find, Dave.
Leland on board that 02. They've had horrible luck, really, over the past couple of seasons. And this, a battle for second now, as Pierre Lecoulette in the EpiPen. Chevrolet Impala goes to second spot.
Alex LaVey closing in to make that a four-car battle, but look at Jason Hathaway with a comfortable advantage.
Pierre Lecoulette, though, what a hot shoe to fill in for Alex Tagliani. Of course, he's off at his regular May duties at the Indianapolis 500. Here comes Pierre Lecoulette, somebody who has one start in the NASCAR Pinty Series, and here he is battling at the front of the field. His career best finish is eighth.
And he's a gifted sports car racer, road racer. He says, I really enjoy driving these stock cars. It doesn't hurt that I'm driving one of the best cars in the field.
He really is back on board the Can-Am sponsored number 32, the Ford Fusion of Alex LaVey. Running a full-time season here in 2016, the 56 of Matthew Skinnell. We should tell you, if you don't see him running near the front of the field, unfortunately, mechanical difficulties, looks like driveline problems for that team.
Yeah, we saw him as the field went by just off of turn five. He got off to a runoff area. Tough break for the young driver from Rockwood, Ontario. And we've got problems at a turn 10. Dion-Vienne got all out of shape. I'm not sure if he had help there or not, Dave.
We'll have another look. You see DJ Kennington tucked in behind the Castrol Edge Dodge, and just a little tap.
Wow, nice save by Dion-Vienne, and Kerry Mix takes evasive action. That was some good driving by all three of them to avoid a problem.
But now a full course caution. Debris in turn number 10 is the reason for that one. And you saw Kaz Grala take to the pits in the 22 a little bit earlier on. And we're riding on board the 47 of LP Dumoulin.
Doesn't make sense to see that contact, as LP would be driving hard into the corner. That was significant damage.
Matthew Skinnell getting a push off the racetrack, but we also had some fireworks into turn number 5. On board, David Thorndike, Brett Taylor in the 46 goes around. Wait.
Wow! Contact between, that's after they spun out together, coming back up to speed.
Pit road's open, Todd.
Just past halfway, our pole sitter taking the opportunity under this caution to make his scheduled stop for four fresh Goodyear tires. Left side of the car is up, the switch going on. Crew will move back around to the right side of the car and replace those four tires as well.
WeatherTech.ca, number 47 of LP Dumoulin will stop to the attention of his crew. He'll pick up his brand new Goodyear Eagles. You see a lot of tire changes going on at the front of the field. Your leader continues to be the number 3 of Jason Hathaway. He's finished his service, and now he's out in front. Welcome back to race number 1 of the 2016 NASCAR Pinty Series from Canadian Tire Motorsport Park. The 46 of the rookie Brett Taylor out of Calgary, Alberta, getting the free pass during that last caution. He'll tag on to the tail of the field as we look for the green flag. Jason Hathaway will lead him down the front straightaway. Pierre Lecoulette to his outside.
A couple of great stories in the front three rows. You've got Kevin Lacroix, who tore that car all up yesterday, and Joey McComb in the 25, who wasn't even supposed to drive this weekend.
Yeah, he's running a fill-in role for Josh Collins, who misses this first race. He should be back at Autodrome Chaudière for race number 2. We'll look forward to seeing him there. But the field stringing out single file through turn number 2 and heading into turn 3.
Once again, Jason Hathaway with a great start, able to open up some advantage. It may not look like much, Dave, but when you have a few car lengths over the car behind you, it really lets you relax a little bit and focus on hitting your marks.
Quick onboard ride with the 74, the bumper-to-bumper Dodge Challenger of Kevin Lacroix. And there you see the 32 of Alex LaVey picking up a couple spots to the inside of JF Dumoulin. Kevin Poitras in the 8 car falling back a little bit. On board with Kaz Grala.
And he's had busy hands every time we've gone on board that car. He's working for his money.
He's a youngster, but you know what? He's made a name for himself in the K&N series. He's made a few starts in the truck series, who will make another stop here at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park during the Labor Day long weekend. So just cutting his teeth, learning this trade.
As we watch the field up through turns 9 and 10, one car peeled off the racetrack in a big hurry. That looks like Simone Dionfien, Dave.
Out of 10th spot, and we're hearing it will be a penalty for jumping the start during that last restart. So the 37 paying a penalty, headed down pit lane, and we have a battle for the lead. Now Hathaway trying to hold off a charge from the 18 of Pierre Lecoulette.
It's funny to watch. Pierre-Luc Ouellette has no rear bumper cover. Jason Hathaway does have one, but it's coated in oil.
Which is interesting. You've been seeing that oil building up over the last several laps, but no smoke from the three of Jason Hathaway. So that's interesting.
And you can see it on the windshield there of Andrew Ranger. We saw some oil on the windshield of Alex LeBay earlier as well, as we were watching his onboard.
Great look at the field run by, and there's a couple of interesting stories at play here today. One is the 84 of Larry Jackson, who's currently in 19th spot, but he has a good sponsor on board.
You know what, Dave? They've got some companies involved with the team, but this weekend he's sponsored by Canadian Blood Services. A close friend of the Jackson family has a young daughter who's had 53 blood transfusions in her life. She has an illness. Larry said he started donating blood. He wants to put Canadian Blood Services on the car. He says you can donate every 56 days. He says if two people decide they want to donate blood because of what we've done with the race team, he says, I'll feel great about that.
And you see on the ticker across the top of your screen the name B. Cathcart. That's Brian Cathcart. And no, this isn't about 5 years ago. That is the same Brian Cathcart who used to race with this series years ago, making a return with Derek Lynch.
He's teamed up with Lynch. He's going to run some road courses. Lynch will run some ovals. And what did their t-shirts say? Oh, forget the t-shirts. The bumper-to-bumper number 74 of Kevin Lacroix off the racetrack, just coasting along.
Now, I was just going to say that I saw him fall off the pace, and you can see the rear end moving, the back tires moving side to side, so that could be the problem. But Don Thompson Jr. off his perch at the top of the pit box. The crew chief, no urgency to his step, so this could be terminal. As you see, the field continues under green. There's a good look at the 87 of Mel Shaw as the leaders buzz past, but he's out of the way, and they're able to get by cleanly. Oh, maybe he isn't quite out of the way.
Big trouble. That's Kaz Grala just coming back to the racetrack. He got airborne in that Descartes number 22, and there's a few others involved as well. That's where Mel Shaw has come to rest on the racetrack, Dave.
The 06 of Carlos De Castana also involved. You see those two cars tied together. Kaz Grala has managed to refire, and he'll get back on the racetrack. But two cars linked together at the entrance of turn number 5, well towards the back of this raceway. And there's Shaw in the Bay Investments, number 87, making his first start in the NASCAR Pinty Series. Started racing way back in 1968.
What a shame for Carlos De Quesada, Dave. He'd been battling inside the top 10 for much of this race.
Adam, we'll have another look at what happened. Here's Mel Shaw in the 87.
Mel had been backing out of it when he was being overtaken and being lapped. He'd been trying to do the right thing by backing out of the throttle to let everybody go by. But sometimes it's hard to judge when the closing rate is so fast, they had nowhere to go.
Whoa, LP wow. Dumoulin did a lot of steering there. Dussault got caught up in it as well. There's the 71, some damage to that Dodge as he'll head down pit lane. I don't know if that's his debris or he's picked it up from somebody else.
What an awkward place to be stopped on the racetrack, Dave. These two drivers still strapped into the car, and all they can do is sit there and look at each other.
And they can make hand gestures. It's the fourth caution of the day, though. Another full course caution here in the Clarington 200. So we'll get that cleaned up. We'll reset the field and bring you back. Jason Hathaway, your leader. What a great crowd here at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park, and just a picture-perfect day to kick off the summer racing season. We're heading for restart number 4. Jason Hathaway continues to lead, but a shout-out to the crew who has managed to make this facility pretty perfect for this weekend.
We can't say enough about Carlo Fadani and Miles Brandt and Ron Fellows, all the team at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park, for the work they continue to do.
Back under green, we've completed 39 laps of a scheduled 50. So we are getting down towards the end of this race. And this is generally, if you look back through the history books, this is when business starts to pick up.
You pull your elbows up and you really start to drive these cars. There's not so much give, there's all sorts of take. At this point of the races, Kerry Mick's way up out of the groove.
Oh, and that's heartbreak as he will get freight trained. A number of cars lined up and ready to go by. And Mick's trying to get that car back into line. Looks like he got up into the marbles, the loose bits on the outside of the racing line. And Kerry, look who that dives out of line as well.
Yeah, that was a bizarre move there. It allowed Alex LaBey to go by DJ Kennington looking for racing room behind him.
And you know what? The driver of the EpiPen Cantor, number 18, went really wide in turn number two. So there may be some issues for that Chevy Impala. We'll keep an eye on him. He's still at speed down the back straightaway.
And the field fans out all through the length of this field of race cars. People looking for a little bit of an opening, trying to find a place to make a move.
Boy, Dumoulin drove it right down to the inside of the raceway, down the back straightaway. He'll tuck back in line, though, behind the Castrol Edge Dodge of DJ Kennington. And there goes Ouellette. So problems for the number 18 of Pierre-Luc Ouellette as he head pit side.
You could tell from the line he was running, something wasn't right on that race car. He was kind of darting high, darting low. He's going to head down to Tyler Case and the rest of the EpiPen crew.
He lost that rear bumper cover much earlier in this race. But slowly, he'll maintain the pit road speed limit and find his crew and figure out whatever is wrong with that number 18. We're hearing possibly a tire down for the 18 of Pierre-Luc Ouellette.
Looks like a right front tire is what they're changing on that race car. Tough break.
So he'll have some work to do. He'll be hoping for a caution and a battle at the front of the field. Andrew Ranger took a look underneath the number 3 of Jason Hathaway. Now he has a run side by side.
It is hard to make that move work. You have to pinch the car off so hard going into turn 5, it's tough to get a run down the straightaway. So that opened the door for LaBey to go to the outside.
You roll the dice and you take your chances, and LaBey has really hit on something special to the outside. The Can-Am Ford Fusion, the number 32, moves to second spot.
If you can pass Andrew Ranger in the last 10 laps or so of a road course race, you're pretty darn good.
There's Ranger hard at work. He looks so comfortable, and he always has.
Very relaxed body position. He knows what he wants to do. He's a gifted race car driver.
Look back to the number 17 of DJ Kennington. 72 consecutive races without a DNF for DJ Kennington. That's something to hang your hat on.
That's pretty impressive as Joey McComb goes around Kerry Mix on the inside of turn one.
You see the innovative plumbing dodge of Anthony Simone in that group as well. He's a little bit off the pace after earlier problems, but using this as a big test session now. And you know what? Could get a couple lucky dogs and get back in this race.
It's never too late. But look at the top five, nose to tail. We're on board with Andrew Ranger in the Mopar Dodge. Shifting through the gears, looks to the inside.
Contact with the 32 of Alex LaBey. And now down the back straightaway. LaBey a little crossways as he got under power.
DJ Kennington, we're getting a good look at the front of that Castrol Edge Dodge. He'll swing to the outside, looking to make a move on his teammate Ranger.
A drag race down the back straightaway. JF Dumoulin is having a great afternoon in the Spectra Premium 04. Will tuck in behind Andrew Ranger, but doesn't have quite enough to make the pass on DJ Kennington.
And he just barely closed the door on Dumoulin before Dumoulin got the nose of that Spectra Premium 04 in there. Kennington again. Try that move on the inside of turn 10.
That, I would say, is DJ Kennington's favorite spot to pass.
It's a risky move because you really have to drive deep into 10. And look at this, Kaden Lapcevich closing in on the leaders.
Oh, and a big hit for the Pilotti number 8 of Kevin Poitras. Obviously, a full course caution here as that car is wadded up in turn number 8.
One of the Canada's best racing team entries, one of the 4 cars in competition here today. Of course, one of the teammates, Mel Shaw, caught up in the last wreck. And now Kevin Poitras with trouble of his own.
And he is out of that race car, the NASCAR medical team with him. But when we return, it will be a green-white checker. Jason Hathaway will lead him here at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park. Welcome back to the opening race of the 2016 NASCAR Pinty Series. Jason Hathaway in his Ray Bestis Chevrolet has led since lap number 19, but not all has gone perfectly for the native of Uxbridge, Ontario.
No, the one thing you have to do so many times cleanly at Canadian Tire Motorsport Park is shift gears, Dave, and we're going to have a look on board. There goes the shifter nut. Look how quickly he discarded of it down into turn number one. That's going to be painful for Hathaway.
Well, he's got to grab that bare shifter knob for the rest of the way. He's got his hand on it. He'll be grabbing a gear here on the front straightaway in no time as we head back for the green flag. LeBay and Hathaway side by side into turn number one. A green white checker to settle it here in the Clarington 200.
They both got a great restart. Look at the distance they pull on the second row. Still door handle to door handle between turns one and two.
And they bump into turn number two. Remember, they're on slick tires, so no traction on a wet track. LeBay makes it through cleanly. So does Ranger. Buck comes through as well. But look, no vision out of the front windshield of the Mopar Dodge.
How is Andrew Ranger going up through the gears? Here we get a good view looking at Robin Buck in the number one machine. LeBay leads down the straightaway. Buck looking for racing room.
DJ Kennington holding on in fourth spot, and here comes LeBay to the inside, but Ranger around the outside.
Something happened to LeBay. He loses to, well,
that's what happened. He can't see anything.
Oh, my goodness. He works through turn number nine, headed for 10. The white flag will be displayed.
He needs a car in front of him to realistically show him the way, just to sort of give him a shape to follow. The white flag is at one more lap to go. Andrew Ranger in the Mopar Pennzoil Dodge, your race leader.
There is no better driver in the history of this series on a wet racetrack than Robin Buck, the driver in second spot. And Ranger high. He's up on the outside in turn number two. Here comes Robin Buck.
Robin Buck able to close the gap, but it is still Alex LeBay holding on to third spot. DJ Kennington right in behind. And Caden Lapcevich battling with the three car. Jason Hathaway just outside the top five.
He got a nose underneath that three machine as we're looking back on the one of Robin Buck. Look at the body roll on these race cars. Look at them slip slide on the asphalt.
It looks like they're driving dirt cars as they tiptoe their way through 5A and B. And Lapcevich gives the three car a shove in 5B. Down the back straightaway they go.
Clearly wet racetrack as we head down the backstretch. LP Dumoulin alongside Hathaway. Hathaway has lost a serious amount of spots. Now Kennington to the outside.
The leader punched a piece of debris down the back straightaway. A fender laying on the Andretti straight. Andrew Ranger hit it. So did DJ Kennington.
Caden Lapcevich, he's up to fourth.
And he's going to be pressuring DJ Kennington through the final set of turns. It's Andrew Ranger through turn number 10 for the final time. And here comes Caden Lapcevich giving the 17 a push. Ranger's going to win race number one. We got problems in behind.
Car spinning in turn 10. Ranger with the win. Buck finishes second. Kennington in third. And who did we lose? Hathaway. The three of Hathaway all the way down to ninth. All hell broke loose on the last lap.
The 21st win for the 27 of Andrew Ranger, and right on board with Jason Hathaway.
Here's Hathaway into 10. Whoa, contact. That's LP Dumoulin in the 47. He lights him up, and Hathaway has to drop the anchor, losing spots on both sides.
LP Dumoulin managed to get it going straight and finish this race, but Andrew Ranger battled not only the competitors, but the weather to take the win. The number 27 Mopar Dodge of Andrew Ranger arrives in victory lane as he wins the Clarington 200.
And how about fourth and fifth place? Caden Lapcevich fourth, LeBay fifth, J.F. Dumoulin with a great run in sixth.
How about the 0-2 of Kerry Mix in the Ford and Simon Dion-Vienne in the 37, seventh and eighth, and Gary Clute recovers for a 10th place finish here today. Let's head down to victory lane with Todd.
Andrew Ranger has slipped off that helmet, unbuckled the harness, and the smile is unmistakable on his face as he climbs out to wave that checkered flag.
with victory in the first NASCAR Pinty Series race of the year. What a debut for that new paint scheme on that Mopar Express Lane. Wow, what an end to this race. That was about as dramatic as you can get.
Oh my God, it's so exciting. I want to thank Mopar Pencil, my team. They worked so hard to put that car. I don't know what to say. It's been that crazy the last two or three laps. The rain came out. I could see a lot. You can see on the wind shear. So I tried my best. I saw Labby slow down on the straightaway, and I passed him on the outside. But, you know, I want to thank again my team, my guys, my wife at home, my baby. So crazy, just happy.
Andrew Ranger, winner of race number one of the NASCAR Pinty Series. Let's go to Tanya, who's with the second place finisher, Robin Buck.
Robin Buck, a crazy race, rain, yellow flags. How did it go?
Well, obviously pretty good at the end. You know, with that rain coming out, it helped us. We took advantage of some guys getting a bit wide in one of the corners and got us up to second.
Great day for the Dodge Dealers of Ontario Advertising Association number one. That deal just came together with Robin Buck.
And of course, the point standings resemble very much the running order at the finishing of this race. And Andrew Ranger, the top step of the podium, and he'll get the trophy from Tony Spiteri from Pinty's. And Todd standing by with Andrew's teammate.
Third place finisher, DJ Kennington with son Chase. Who's going to do the interview, you or him? Maybe we'll start with you
he can
and
if you want.
See how it goes. But what a great finish for you to start off this season.
Yeah, it was a good day for the Castrol Edge Dodge. You know, we got to start the season off great. It's a road course. Everybody knows my road course stuff's mediocre on my behalf. But, you know, another solid top three finish here at Canadian Tire Motorsports Park for us. And thanks to Pinty's, Castrol, all my sponsors, Brian Cathcart, everybody that helps us out. It's a great start to the season, and for better things to come, it's on its way.
Well done.
Thank you.
Big day for DJK Racing, first and third this afternoon, Dave.
This NASCAR race is brought to you by E3 Spark Plugs, born to burn. By Pinty's, making great food fun. By Bennett Golf Cars and Utility Vehicles. Visit BennettGolfCars.ca. And by WeatherTech, the ultimate interior protection for your vehicle.
What a spectacular way to start the season. Three Dodges on the podium at CTMP, Dave.
Six lead changes today in a race that pretty much had everything as we welcome a new era in NASCAR racing in Canada for Todd and Tanya and Adam up here in the booth. I'm Dave Bradley. We look forward to seeing you next time from Autodrome Chaudière.
This copyrighted telecast may not be reproduced, retransmitted, or used in any form without the authorized written consent of NASCAR Broadcasting. NASCAR would like to thank all of our fans for your support, and we hope you enjoy today's broadcast.